Democratic Congresswoman Rashida Tlaib has been facing some pretty severe backlash following her response to Hamas's terror attack on Israeli civilians. Now she's getting some backlash for flying the Palestinian flag near her office. Now I'm gonna get to that part in just a moment, but just as a reminder for why she initially faced backlash, her initial statement in response to what Hamas did was, "I grieve the Palestinian and Israeli lives lost yesterday, today, and every day. I am determined as ever to fight for a just future. The path to that future must include lifting the blockade, ending the occupation, and dismantling the apartheid system that creates the suffocating, dehumanizing conditions that can lead to resistance. As long as our country provides billions in unconditional funding to support the apartheid government, this heartbreaking cycle of violence will continue." Now, it might be okay for her to put a statement like that out had Hamas not murdered nearly 1,000 Israeli civilians, but doing that right after news breaks of what Hamas did, maybe not such a great idea. So she gets the backlash. I agree with that backlash. Just gonna keep it real with you guys, okay? But what I do not agree with is the backlash she's getting for flying the Palestinian flag as an American, as a Palestinian American. Because the Palestinian flag is not the same as the Hamas flag, and going after her for that, I think makes no sense. But let me give you the full story. So she's continuing to fly the Palestinian flag outside of her congressional office. There it is, there's an image of it. Rhys Gorman tweeted about it saying, "New Representative Rashida Tlaib has a Palestinian flag hanging outside of her house office amid Hamas's invasion of Israel." But it's not a Hamas flag, it is a Palestinian flag. Palestinian civilians exist, their culture exists. The idea that she needs to denounce her own, like the Palestinian flag as, again, a Palestinian American makes no sense to me. But former Israeli ambassador to the United Nations, Danny Danon, went on Fox News and of course decided to discuss his reaction to Tlaib's actions. Let's watch.
Mr. Ambassador, what's your reaction to our Congresswoman Rashida Tlaib? She's a Democrat and she is flying this Palestinian flag outside of her office and put out a statement blaming Israel, blaming your apartheid government for what's happening.
Rashida Tlaib, she's a disgrace. Shame on her for such a behavior. You know, imagine that in her hometown in Detroit, Michigan, 1,000 people would have been kidnapped and killed. Children, families. How can she even identify herself with such brutality? I think the people of Michigan should send her home. I know it doesn't represent the American people. We know that we have the support. People pray for us every day. And I can tell them we are grateful for that. And we will prevail. We are in the past, in Yom Kippur, we were in a similar situation. But together with the support of the US, we fought back and we won the war. That's what will happen also in this war.
Now, you also have Republican lawmakers like Congressman Max Miller introducing measures to ban the Palestinian flag, among others. He wrote on X, formerly known as Twitter, "The halls of Congress belong to America. They should be reserved for flags that embody our great nation. The Palestinian flag should not have a place here. That's why I sponsored an appropriations amendment to end this silliness." And his amendment stipulates, "None of the funds made available by this act may be used to acquire or display any flag or pennant other than the flag of the United States, the flag or pennant of any state or territory or possession of the United States, or the POW MIA flag."
Yeah, so I agree with you completely, Anna. So as I said yesterday on the coverage, yesterday was not the day to talk about, you know, to voluntarily bring up the idea of apartheid, etc. It was just poor form to say the least, because people are suffering and they're, you know, they've got family members there, etc. That's not the day to agitate on that. It doesn't mean the occupation isn't wrong. The occupation is wrong. It's not a productive way to handle it, in my opinion. Okay. The Palestinian flag, I agree with Anna. It's the flag of Palestinians, it's not Hamas. You fly the Hamas flag, then I'm livid. And then I agree with everybody, okay? But as now the Palestinians are getting crushed, and you could largely blame Hamas for that. If you anybody can blame anyone they like, okay? But the Palestinians are getting crushed right now, okay? So you want to have sympathy for the Palestinians, you put up the Palestinian flag today. I get it, right? And those are people, those are people. So, but I'm actually less mad at the two, you know, the Israeli ambassador and the Republican than when I first saw the headlines, because I thought he was, the Israeli ambassador was saying that it was a disgrace that she put up the Palestinian flag. Like, well, that's unacceptable to say that, but he didn't. If you see the full context there, he could have been referring to disgrace as to the comments about Hamas and comments about apartheid, etc. And of course, he's the Israeli ambassador. He gets to say that today, right? And for Max Miller, at first I thought he was just going to try to ban the Palestinian flag, and that's just absurd and silly. But his resolution, to be fair, says all non-American flags and non-state flags, and that I could live with. And look, everybody to each his own, and everybody does different things. If I was in Congress, I'm Turkish American, I'd never put up the Turkish flag. It's not because I'm not proud to be ethnically Turkish, okay? But I'm an American, and I'm in the American house. And so I just don't see it there. But that's just up to them. So I don't think there's anything wrong with the Palestinian flag at all. But the rest of it is problematic.
Also, I mean, what Max Miller is doing is basically theater, because his amendment notes, it stipulates that no government funding can go toward any of these flags. I don't think the government paid for Rashida Tlaib's Palestinian flag.
Yeah.
So again, it appears to be, you know, some chest puffing and all of that. But I want everyone to know the difference between the Palestinian flag, because look, to me, the most important thing is protecting civilians, right? When it comes to this conflict, what breaks my heart is watching civilians, whether it's on the Israeli side or the Palestinian side, getting crushed and murdered as a result of what's going on. Hamas's flags look like this. So let's go to graphic 5. So one of them has that seal, the other has some writing with the green flag. The Palestinian flag, the flag of the Palestinian people, looks like this, and that is what was flying, or what that is what Rashida Tlaib had hanging right outside of her congressional office. And look, whenever these terrible conflicts and wars happen, emotions run high. I totally get that. But you have to differentiate between the bad guys and ordinary people, ordinary civilians. Yeah. Right? So for instance, let's think about it in a different context. I hate what the Russian government is doing with their brutal and disgusting war and invasion in Ukraine. I do not hate the Russian people. I don't think Russian civilians should suffer as a result of that. So we have to be able to make those distinctions. We need to care about humanity, human lives, and again, civilians, protecting them and sticking up for them when, you know, especially when emotions run wild.
Yeah, so I hate what the American government did in Iraq. I don't hate Americans. And in terms of the civilians, Hamas is, yes, you know, now I see all over, everywhere, online, everywhere else saying, well, the Palestinians voted for Hamas. Don't go down that road. That's a terrible road, because the Israelis voted for Netanyahu. So under that logic, you say, well, then the Israeli civilians, it's a do not do that, do not do that. That's terrible. By the way, that goes a billion times more for Hamas. You claim that your problem was with the Israeli government, then you murdered innocent Israeli civilians. So then how do you say, oh, don't murder innocent Palestinian civilians? Well, you just did it. You just did it to them. So now you've lost all moral high ground, but we're not, for all of us, the decent people that get caught in the middle of these extremists all the time, for us, it's gotta matter that it's civilians or a terrorist group or a government doing something wrong, whether it's the American government, Israeli government, or a terrorist group like Hamas doing something wrong. We cannot then lay that blame on all Palestinians or all Israelis or all Muslims or all Jews or all Americans or all Russians. We cannot do that, because we have, the only way out of this mess eventually is for all of us to realize we're all human beings. We're all nearly identical. Our DNA is so incredibly similar. We're the same species. Stop killing each other and stop listening to people who tell you to kill each other. And the minute they tell you to kill someone innocent is the minute you should walk out. It's not complicated.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.